In the previous episode, we worked on putting down the post of the freestanding pergola. And as you can see, all four posts are in here now. Some of them are freshly laid, so they're still drying out. So I won't be able to do much with them today. But this means that we could start working on the next steps, which is to plan out and mark where the horizontal beams would go. Basically, everything that goes on top. In this episode, we're going to focus on all of the top elements of the structure. So let's get started. One of the things that we have to do is to work out where the arches sit. And what we have to do here is to mark out where we would be creating the notch. So in this case, it would be somewhere around here and this deep. So maybe we would chop half of this. And we're going to do that for both set of posts, each arch. That way we can be sure that each of these horizontal beams would fit their intended locations. Once we have laid down the support beams, we are going to mark out where each of these horizontal beams would sit. Imagine that these two support beams are already on the arch. Basically, we'll just mark down here and maybe get a third or a half of this of the length. And once we have the notch on both sides, it's as simple as just slotting it in and driving nails on top of them. Now that I've worked out my next steps, I think I'm going to call it a day. I still need to give it time to set. So here's where we're at so far. As you can see, we have a basic frame standing now. We have got all of the four posts in now and they are set in cement. That way they do not move around, especially when we have our strong winds. And earlier today, we also worked on connecting the entire frame. We have both arches in now. And we also put in some of the horizontal beams, the one in front and the one at the back. Having the cubic structure in there would make it easier for us to determine if everything is aligned or straight. And if we happen to run into any problems with alignment, at least we could adjust on both sides and better to know earlier than later. We made a tiny mistake when we were setting out the width or the length of this beam, which connects the front and the back post. We run short of a few millimeters at the back. Apparently, we dug the front hole too far enough to leave a gap at the back. But thankfully, the gap was just wide enough for one of the horizontal planks to sit in. So it all worked out in the end. So the back horizontal beam is nailed to both of the arches. And at least it provides a nice bit of support. Well, the front is sitting exactly where I want it to sit. And as you can see, there are three different pieces of timber that are interacting on this corner right here. So we have this post forming the base of the structure. And sitting on top of it would be this beam, which goes from front to back. And finally, we have one of the horizontal beams. This is the front one. We made some notches on them. That way they would slot in together like a jigsaw puzzle. And with all of those notches in, they're going to support each other. That way they would not move around. And the presence of strong winds would not be able to tear them apart. Basically, we're relying on friction and other mechanical forces to help with keeping everything stable. We are not solely depending on the strength of the nails. Having done the front and back beams, working on the rest of the beams was an easy task because all we had to do was to mark where it would be sitting on top of the front to back beams. And once we have determined the placement, we just had to mark them and make the notches accordingly. So each beam has two notches, one on either side. This would allow us to slot them right in and we just have to nail them down into the rest of the support. So I just have to mount this on and it's hammer time. I know that we still have to drive the nails in, but you must admit, it looks really nice now. Now that all of the nails have been driven in, all that's left is to seal the structure. Some of you have suggested that I should just probably seal and stain the whole thing, because the natural colors of the wood might look nice. I would agree normally, but you know, I want to hide the ugly joints such as this one. I think they would be very obvious even if I use wood cement or was it grout. But in any case, I'll be painting over it and hopefully I haven't decided on the color yet. My My top pick would be something light, maybe even just white, but we'll see. For now, I'm just going to use the leftover paint that we use on the exterior of our house. It is weatherproof paint, UV resistant and all of that stuff. So yeah, I think it should suit just fine, at least for now. Painting the whole thing will take a while, so I'll be back. It has actually been 3 days since the last scene, and a lot has happened since then. So earlier this week, we finished painting this pergola. We went with this grayish blue paint, which is actually leftovers from us painting the front. We also celebrated Nikki's birthday yesterday. She turned 2 years old, so that was fun.
Her birthday was last Friday, the 6th of December. I've been busy with work and other projects, so this episode has been sitting raw and unedited for another week.
I was originally planning to use white on my pergola, but now that I'm looking at the colors, you know, it's starting to grow on me, and I think it looks nice. It doesn't scream too much, and I guess placing plants to contrast against it would really work, because against that type of color, the plants will definitely stand out. So I might leave it as is, unless I really have a strong urge to change it, but no such urge for now. I'm really happy with how it turned out. I haven't tallied how much it costed me, but I have a feeling that it was pretty close to $500, maybe in the range of $400. And you know what, I'm going to create a tally and display it over here once I get to editing. But yeah, this would be the figures in case you wanted to do something similar, or at least based on the prices that you would see here in Australia, in Bunnings mainly. So we're finished with the pergola structure, but we're no way finished with the entire project yet. Because if you would remember, the whole motivation behind this project was to create some sort of shade structure for my plants. This one isn't providing shade yet. It's still wide open. It has no cover on top of it. So in the next episode, we're finally going to finish the shade aspect of this project. And by then, we're going to apply all of the finishing touches that would make the project complete. So if you do not want to miss out, make sure to subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.